Welcome to the Cosnetic Podcast.
This podcast amplifies the topics you want to hear about.
Cosnetic means being a person or thing that gives rise to something that is dynamic or energizing.
Globally minded and locally focused.
I'm Keith Benson.
And I'm Rodrigo Ross.
And today we're talking about volunteering. Is that your time is our treasure.
Right. So working with a nonprofit, like the idea, the role, the need for volunteers is incredible. Like, it is the backbone of getting work done in a nonprofit.
Yeah, I mean, so when you I think about, man, it's going over the years that I volunteered as a soccer coach and the value that I brought to my players.
Did y'all win? Well, Okay. Never mind. I retract the question.
Retract the question on that. Well, but my value.
Did you have value if y'all didn't win?
Well, my time.
My time was valuable.
Yeah, my skill set, what I had to offer. Okay, that might be a little questionable.
I think we should poll the kids.
I would say that the kids would probably say my time was good.
You coached them? On what to say, clearly not in soccer, but on what to say.
Okay, so let's get back to the topic of volunteering.
Okay, yeah.
You know, volunteers are very important. So when you talk about nonprofit organizations, the volunteers are the backbone to make it happen.
Absolutely. So, you know, the thing that I love about volunteering as it relates to this whole idea of philanthropy, right? So nonprofits rely heavily on philanthropic efforts. But many people think of philanthropy as just money. But according to Webster's dictionary, philanthropy is an act or a gift made for humanitarian purposes. So, you know, when you're talking about volunteering, especially in cash-strapped neighborhoods, I think it's really important that we reframe the narrative so people understand, yes, volunteering is just as helpful and as important as making a monetary gift.
So, in talking and reading some stats, the Office of National Statistics says that in 2014, based on around 2 billion volunteer hours, that total, that worth was $23
billion. $23
billion. And so how does a nonprofit operate if they don't have volunteers?
They don't, not well.
Right.
You can't. And you got to have, you know, volunteers. Number one, you got to have them in meaningful work, right? It has to be a win-win for both of you. They have to be doing what they love, what they feel passionate about, and what they feel like they're moving the needle on. But you also have to be getting some stuff done. I mean, in many cases, unfortunately, sometimes in an effort to appease volunteers, it makes more work for the staff people at the nonprofit.
So as a nonprofit leader, you have to be able to take your volunteers and put them in the place that they can be successful at. And you got to be able to have a plan. So many times that what we'll do is that we'll plan a whole event and say, hey, volunteers, come the day of and do this. And you get these volunteers that are not as engaged.
Yeah.
So, like, we got to back up and put the volunteers in the planning
seat. The whole process. Absolutely. Like, even if you just told them, hey, this is what success looks like. Can you guys make this happen and get out of the way?
Because I'm assuming that you're going to recruit the best volunteers to be able to do and not somebody who can't do a particular skill set. And so it's like people want to give their time. We already see the value in that when you put a dollar amount to. I believe that comes out to like $14, $15 an hour and probably more depending on, you know, the skill set of the particular volunteer.
You know, for some volunteers, that's key. So, you know, my experience has been that we have lots of people who engage with a branch who don't necessarily have the means to give you money, but they will give you lots and lots of their time. But when we do recognitions, you know, we always do recognitions from the monetary base. But the reality is, if we're talking about a $14 to $15 an hour, you know, rate value for volunteer hours, that means that that person who probably would have been working or hustling up some money or some resources for their family just decided not to do that, not to make that money, not to do that thing and give give you that time and help, you know, make that why better, make that community better. And that says a lot.
Yeah. And so, I mean, there's benefits to volunteering also. Mm-hmm. And so, I mean, people do it for different reasons. One, for enjoyment. Like, yeah. I want to be able to do something on my own time that I truly enjoy. Some people, you know, selfishly do it for self-esteem. You know, they need a little something to, you know, get patted on the back. Mm-hmm. Yeah, hey, you know. Mm-hmm. But then it's also this personal development space also. And so, man, I don't have, you know, the work experience in a particular area. So let me go and volunteer in a space so I can develop this certain skill set.
Great way
and
to
so,
get skills.
Especially when we talk about if you are transitioning from a career, that may be one window. Mm-hmm. If you're coming fresh out of college and you need some different experience, mm-hmm. but people do value that volunteer experience.
Because the
that
skill
they may
set
have.
Is the yeah. skill set. And some people are voluntold. Like, I get lots of my volunteers that way.
Yeah.
I just voluntold
yeah.
Hey, you.
Yeah, you come. Hey, would you mind helping me out? I got an event.
Oh, you say, would you mind?
Yeah.
That's nice.
Oh.
I don't.
No.
No.
Wow.
No.
And so, well, I guess for those who want to come and volunteer to help reduce their stress level, maybe not so much with you?
Maybe.
Okay.
I don't know.
But some people do volunteer just so that they can reduce stress. They're tired of the space that they're in. So let me come in here and do something that I feel good about so that I can reduce my stress
well,
level.
Well, eventually we'll get there. And I'm going to always be funny. And I'm going to always have on cute shoes. So, I mean, it's a win.
Funny and cute shoes.
Yes.
Hmm.
It's a win. Everybody loves that.
Yeah, but your shoe game is okay.
Okay.
Yeah, and then you're funny.
Are you serious right now? Did you just say my shoe game is okay?
Yeah.
Okay. The levels of shade right now.
Yeah, but we need volunteers to be successful. So when we talk about developing our boards, and so yeah. we need this mindset, this very strategic mindset of how we're going to provide direction for our particular organization. So that's one level right there.
Yeah.
But then for the YMCA, when we look at our youth sports program would not be able to operate if
absolutely
it was not,
not
for volunteers.
Between the coaches, the team moms, the refs in some instances, all kinds of people just out there lending a hand because, you know, we definitely want the kids to build skills in that sport. But what we're really teaching them is core values and mm-hmm. sportsmanship and just helping them navigate through life situations. And we need folks to help us with that.
And one of the things that we're implementing right now is character development. I mean, we always kind of had these core values of caring, honesty, respect, and responsibility. Mm-hmm. But now we're looking at these practice areas. So we have five practice areas that we're implementing into our program. And it is led by the concept of making sure that these adults role model the behavior of character development that we want seen. And so our practice areas are personal development, relationship building, responsibility, empathy, emotional management, and all of those things. We're saying that adults, you have to be able to model these different things. And so how are you developing that how are you developing yourself so that individual that you may be coaching on the soccer, on the basketball court.
Mm-hmm.
When you talk about, you know, relationship building, again, how are you working with the parents? Are the kids seeing that you're working with the parents in such a way? And then, you know, hey, for your parents, sidebar here, you got to be able to help the coach also, okay?
Well,
with some cases.
This is from your coaching lens.
No. I'm going to say if you talk to, I just finished coaching the soccer team.
The losing soccer team that we talked about earlier.
Hey, but I tell you what, I bet you I got more love from the parents and the kids.
Well,
I'm
sure
coach.
They did. They felt sorry for you because y'all kept losing. It's sweet, though. You tried.
And the YMCA is all about everybody wins, folks.
Well, and you definitely made the best use of that.
And why, as I said, the empathy is one of our character development behaviors here. Mm-hmm. We're going to show that as we have this conversation as well.
Good job coaching, Keith. Those kids loved losing with you every week. It was great. Yeah.
And so our volunteers are valuable to us, and we want to make sure that they have success. We have the character development, like I said, process set up and involved in our team programs and our youth sports programs, our school aid services program. We want to make sure that people that come on board, and as we talk about volunteering, you know, there's this whole safety part as well. And so one of the things that the YMCA does is that we make sure that we background check all of our volunteers.
Even
so,
policy volunteers. Yep, absolutely.
So if you're serving on the board, if you're serving in youth sports, in our youth programs,
if
we do
you're
a background
helping full towels, if you're answering the phones at our welcome centers, everyone in our facilities.
Because we want to make sure that our young people are safe that is involved in any of our programs.
You know, the other thing I would say about volunteering, at least for me, volunteering allows me to get involved outside of what I do every day, right? So mm-hmm. when I look to volunteer somewhere, it is definitely in a space that I don't want to be the leader. I don't want to be in charge. I want to do something different that just kind of helps me feel multidimensional. So lots of our volunteers, especially on my board, they may by trade be in one occupation, but they may sit and contribute to that board in a totally different space. So, for instance, I have a lawyer who's on my board, but his greatest contribution is in all stuff facilities. Like, he loves to come in and help clean up, and he helps paint, and he'll do gardening, and he'll help advocate to raise money, you know, to get new furniture. Like, the last thing he wants to do when he comes to us is more law stuff.
Yeah, I volunteer at my church, and for a hobby, I do photography, and that's what I do. And like, my pastor asked me, well, how come you don't lead a small group? Like, I don't want to be a leader.
Yeah.
And here's my skill set. Here's a skill set that I have that I'm trying to grow, and that's what, like, I enjoy. And so I give my time in that way right there.
Yeah.
You know, many of you all who are listening to us today, you may want to volunteer also. I will tell you that you can go to www.ymcadallas.org and take a look at the different opportunities that are on our website to be able to volunteer.
And as always, thank you for listening to Cosnetic.
Well, where our conversations are global.
Global?
No. Local.
Global. Oh, globally minded and locally focused.
Check us out at ymcadallas.org/cosnetic.
And as always,
stay dynamic.
Stay energized.
Stay cosnetic.